Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 2288, Data Profiling in Power Query. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Well, a great question came in today. Someone was trying to use the filters and said, wouldn't it be cool if here next to each filter item in the drop-down menu, a count would appear so that way you could see how many there were in each item. And I said, oh, that is a good idea. I bet someone on UserVoice already has this. And sure enough, there's one out there, but only 10 votes. Let's see if we can get that up. That would be a great thing. So down in the YouTube description, I'll put a link to this this URL here. If you could go give us a vote, that would be great. But I said, you know, I know that there's a feature coming in Power Query. I just don't know if it's there yet, right? So I went into Insert Table, make my data here into a table, and then on the Data tab, say from Table or Range. You know, and at first, like nothing looked like there was anything new, right? But I said, all right, where would they have put this? Not transform, not add column. Let's see what's out there on view. And sure enough, bam, on view, we now have this awesome new set of things. First off, we can see things in monospace in case you want to see if things are really lined up or not. So we have that one. Column quality shows whether or not there's any error. So here everything is 100% valid. No errors, no empty. If there were errors, then you can come in here and keep errors or keep duplicates or remove empty or remove errors. So nice little bit of UI there. And then column distribution. So I choose a column. Actually, you don't have to choose a column. They're going to show it for all. So here in region, I have three distinct, zero unique. In date, 440 distinct, 340 unique. Seven distinct sectors, none unique. Customers, 27 distinct customers, 10 distinct quantities. Which kind of shows that this data might be fake data, right? And then the other one here, let's take customer, and we ask for the column profile, and it will show us that there's 563 values there, 27 distinct values. The smallest item is ABC stores, the largest is Walmart, and when I hover, there's 66 rows for Exxon, 65 rows for Walmart. I'm going to choose another column, and I get to see those items, right? I saw this in, you know, a beta out of the Microsoft Summit, I don't know, a year ago, 2 years ago, and I kept hearing, oh, this is coming, right? And I said, well, that'll be great when it gets there, but it's here. At least in Office Insiders, it's here, so check it out. You know, I didn't get an email saying, hey, this is the greatest thing ever, go check it out. I just was hiding back there on the View tab. Although, the cool thing is, once you've turned it on, now the next time that I come in to Power Query, then those that column distribution will be there, so it remembers the steps from the last time. Kind of like if you turn on the formula bar, then it stays on from the last time, right? So this is great. This is cool. You know, it's not what the person wanted with the filters, but it'll still give you an idea of the top 10 in the column. And in this case, where there were only 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, yeah, that'll be absolutely, absolutely perfect. Well, we're coming down to the end here. I'm retiring from traveling to seminars. We have three left, out of state, Chicago, and then just outside of Appleton, Wisconsin, and Chattanooga, Tennessee. Beyond those, I'll still be doing seminars in Gainesville, Florida. Click that other link down there in the YouTube description to come check that out. If you like what you see here, please subscribe and ring the bell. Feel free to post any questions or comments down in the comments section below. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.